Professor Dave and Chegg here, we just learned about enantiomers, so we know that they are pairs of molecules which are non-identical mirror images of one another. But what does this have to do with how molecules behave? Do enantiomers have any different properties? Let's investigate.
Given that enantiomers are precise mirror images, they have nearly identical physical properties. They have exactly the same density, polarity, melting point, and boiling point. One way of distinguishing between a pair of enantiomers has to do with the direction that they rotate plane-polarized light. When a beam of ordinary light passes through something called a polarizer, only the light oscillating in a particular plane will pass through, and this is said to be plane-polarized, as light oscillating along any other plane is blocked out. Any chiral compound will be optically active, meaning that it will rotate plane-polarized light by some angle, depending on the structure of the molecule, as measured by and analyzed on the other side of the molecule with respect to the light source. When looking at a pair of enantiomers, they will rotate this light by the same angle, but in opposite directions. One will be dextrorotatory, signified with a plus sign, meaning the rotation is clockwise, and the other will be levorotatory, signified with a minus sign, meaning the rotation is counterclockwise. We can measure the optical activity of many different compounds and tabulate them, and testing the optical activity of a sample is a way of determining the enantiomeric purity of the sample. If both enantiomers are present in equal amounts, the dextrorotatory and levorotatory activity will cancel out, and the sample will not be optically active overall. If one enantiomer is pure, it will rotate the light according to the tabulated value for that enantiomer. And then, if the optical activity is some fraction of that of the pure enantiomer, we can do math to find out the ratio of one enantiomer to the other in the sample.
And so, we now have a little more context surrounding the concept of enantiomers in the way of a specific application, namely a physical property that differs from one enantiomer to the other. We can think of optically active as more or less a synonym for chiral, but we also now know exactly what the term means. Professor Dave for Chegg, see you next time.